$49,000 per year in income, or around $4,000 per month in dividends and distributions, might seem like a super unattainable goal to hit. But with so many high yielding and even ultra high yielding ETFs across the market these days, you don't need as much money invested into some assets in order to generate a ton of income compared to maybe times in the past. Now, in this video specifically, I'm going to go through seven different methods, seven different ETFs that all offer higher than average starting yields and could definitely be the ticket to financial freedom and earn you north of $49,000 per year in income much, much faster. So if you want to see which seven ETFs I'm talking about and see some of my favorite higher yielders across the market as of right now, make sure to stick around, drop a like down below, and let's get right into it. Real quick, for those that haven't already, make sure to go to the first link in my description and grab my new dividend investing ebook, where I share exactly how I went from $0 invested to now earning over $6,000 on a monthly basis and over $1 million invested in the market. Along with the ebook, you're also going to receive my custom dividend tracker, where you can track your dividend progress on an ongoing basis and reach your dividend investing goals. So make sure to grab yourself a copy of my dividend investing ebook and the new dividend tracker today. It's the first link in my description. So starting off on the lower yielding end of things, and as the video goes on, we're going to get into higher and higher yield. So make sure to stick around until the end. But first off, one of my favorites is, of course, DEVO, or the Amplify CWP Enhanced Dividend Income ETF, which yields around 4.5%. And the way that it does so, it buys into a basket of holdings, around 42 different holdings, and then utilizes a cover call strategy in order to earn investors a ton of distributions a lot faster than you would earn by investing into these holdings on their own. Now, for the context of this video, we're going to be shooting for around $4,100 per month in income. That's going to be the goal. So we're going to have to see exactly how much we're going to have to invest into each one of these rather high yielding ETFs in order to achieve that $49,000 goal, or around $4,100 per month. Now, because DEVO ETF currently pays around 15 cents more or less per share per month, as far as income goes, if we wanted to reach $4,100 per month or 49K per year, an investor would need to invest around 27,000 shares of DEVO, which currently costs around $40 per share. So an investor would need to invest over $1 million, around $1,093,000, in order to earn $49,000 per year in income. But stay tuned, because the next options are going to get you there a lot faster. The next option being one of my favorites across the entire market, I'm talking about JEPQ, or the JP Morgan NASDAQ Equity Premium Income ETF. This has been in my portfolio for several years now and has been paying me massive dividends basically every single month of holding it. Now, JEPQ currently has run a 9.9% forward yield. So this ETF specifically is going to give you about double the amount of income for the same amount of money invested of that compared to DEVO. Now, because once again, we're trying to reach $4,100 per month, and because JEPQ specifically pays us around 42 cents per share per month, we would need to own around 9,700 shares of JEPQ in order to earn $49,000 per year, more or less as far as income goes. Now, because JEPQ currently costs around $53 per share, an investor would need to invest around $517,000 into this one in order to be potentially financially free and earn around $49,000 per year in income. So even though 500K is still a ton of money to invest, it's almost half of that of what we would have had to invest if we were looking at DEVO. But now we're really going to start to get into some of the higher yielding territory, so you are definitely going to want to listen in. SPYI, the NEO's S&P 500 High Income ETF. This ETF once again pays monthly. It has a 12.34% distribution rate, has a positive total return, a relatively cheap expense ratio. This is one of my favorite higher income ETFs across the entire market, in my opinion. But more importantly, SPYI pays around 50 cents per share per month. So if we were to try to reach 49K or $4,100 per month, we would need to invest into around 8,200 shares of this one, which this ETF currently costs around $50 per share. So we're talking only $410,000 in order to reach $49,000 per year in income. But it's going to get even better and easier. This ETF, QQQI, the NEO's NASDAQ 100 High Income ETF, sort of the brother to SPYI. This one just tracks the NASDAQ. This also pays monthly and also has a massive distribution rate of around 14-15%. So as you guessed, this one's going to get you there even faster. Now, QQQI pays around 60 cents per share per month, or at least has historically. So we would need only around 6,800 shares of this one, which once again costs around $50 per share. We're talking 341K invested in order to earn $49,000 per year, or around $4,100 per month. But now it's time to get into some of the fun stuff. SVOL or SVOL, these are some of the ultra high yielders. So this ETF more or less shorts the volatility index, or the VIX. It says the Simplified Volatility Premium ETF, or SVOL, seeks to provide investment results before fees and expenses that correspond to approximately 1/5 to 3/10 the inverse of the performance of the CBOE volatility index. SVOL offers around a 16 or 17% yield and pays around 30 cents in distributions more or less every single month, at least it has historically. Now, if we're trying to get to $4,100 per month and SFL pays us around 30 cents per share per month, that means we would have to buy around 13,666 shares, which currently cost around $22 per share. So we're talking just over $300K, invest into this one potentially in order to earn around $49,000 per year in income. Now, another one of my favorite ultra high yielders, this is a new position in my portfolio actually, Defiance S&P 500 Income Target ETF, SPYT. Definitely look into this one if you haven't already, a little bit deeper. 20% distribution rate, and it's been paying a consistent distribution of around 32, 33, 34 cents ever since inception. Now, as far as SPYT goes, we would need to buy around 12,442 shares of it. But the good thing is this ETF is relatively cheap, $20 per share, so 248K invested in order to potentially earn $49,000 per year or around $4,100 per month in income. Now, last but not least, the heavy hitter QDTE. I'm sure this ETF has been on your radar as of recently. It's been getting very, very popular. We're talking 67% distribution rate and an ETF that pays distributions weekly. Now, if we were to average out exactly how much this ETF has paid over the past, say, several months, we're talking around $1.20 per share per month, which means in theory, you need to buy around 3,400 shares of this one in order to earn somewhere of around $49,000 per year. And considering this ETF costs around $45 per share, we're talking $153,000 invested into this one, in theory at least, in order to earn $49,000 per year in income. Now, even though a lot of this goes without saying, I have to always include this in videos like this. Just because an ETF or a stock yields, say, 20, 30, 40, 60% does not by any means mean that it's the best investment or the right investment for your portfolio. And just because a stock or ETF yields a small amount doesn't mean it's the worst investment. Dividend yield or distribution rate is just one of many metrics that an investor should look into when deciding if or if not a stock or ETF is the right pick for their portfolio. But I do think that it's fun to talk about, fun to think about, and definitely fun to make videos like this one to go through and see exactly what it would take potentially in order to earn $49,000 per year in dividends or around $4,100 per month. Because let's be real here, a lot of us could not only potentially live off of $4,000 per month, but if not $4,000 per month in income consistently would definitely lighten the burden and help us a lot as far as our overall expenses. At least I'm talking about me specifically. Now, as you can see throughout my long-term portfolio, I own tons of different equities, different ETFs that yield low yield, high yield, and everything else in between. But I personally do enjoy investing into some of those higher yield options like the ones we went through in today's video, because I personally am trying to get my total monthly dividend income up as fast as possible, as much as possible, in the safest way as possible. But in the talks of earning $49,000, $4,100 per month, or in the talks in general of earning a ton of dividend income and distributions moving forward, I lastly want to hear from you guys down below. What's the number one ETF that you think I should look into as far as an ETF that yields a ton and offers a safe investment strategy? Drop the ticker symbol in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to please drop a like in it and subscribe for more future content like this. Thanks as always for stopping by, and if you are interested in investing, make sure to check out these recent videos I posted right here.